Hi, greetings, fellow Rotarians of the Rotary Club of Visalia. I'm your president, Paul Hurley. It's great to be seeing you again, or being seen again, I'm not sure. It's really getting confusing. This is the sixth of these video messages that I've been sending out to members, and I hope you've been enjoying them. I tell you what, the longer this goes, though, the less fun they're getting to do, and it seems like the longer we stay in this lockdown, the less there is to say about it. I've been continuing to communicate with members, hopefully to share information, keep up to date, to let them know what's going on and what they can expect, to engage with members, and hopefully to keep you motivated to continue with your activities as club members. We are still doing a lot. We're making contributions to our community, and hopefully we are making a difference as people of action. Remember, our motto is connect, serve, and celebrate. And this is the connect part, and eventually we're gonna get to the celebrating part, I hope. I hope it happens before I step down as president, which is just 2 months from now. Last week at our virtual meeting on Wednesday, our member Randy Smith updated you all on our district cemetery project. We've made a lot of progress. In fact, it's almost done except for some of the touch-ups. And Randy had some photos of we'll keep you updated on when what we're doing with that, and hopefully fairly soon we'll have a date where we can all go out there and celebrate this great project. Traveling Rotarian Dave Miller has been traveling, sort of. He shared some photos of the Yoco Valley, a trip down the Yoco Valley with Wildflowers last week at our virtual meeting on Wednesday. And I hope you enjoyed that. And maybe some of the rest of you have some slides or some experiences you'd like to share as a traveling Rotarian. Bring them on. We'll put them in our virtual meeting on Wednesday, or maybe this video update that I'm sending out every week. The County Center Rotary, Tom Hornburg, the esteemed president of County Center and a friend of mine, joined us on Wednesday to report on what his club has been doing. It's kind of interesting. Tom's been doing a weekly report to his members, a meeting, and he does everything like raise the flag and say a prayer. And God bless Tom. Anyway, their club did their annual Taste the Wine Country fundraiser, and you would think that they would have really taken a big hit on it. Maybe they could have done better, but Tom said they raised $114,000. So good for them. God bless them. That's terrific that they would be able to raise that much money, considering that nobody could go. It was virtual. It was all virtual on BidPal, and they raised a good lot of money. So congratulations to County Center Rotary. And I'm going to be checking in with all our Rotary clubs in Visalia and see how they're doing. Hopefully report to you on how they are, because we want to hear about how other people are doing too, right? Also on Wednesday, Trish Stever-Blattler, the director of the Tulare County Farm Bureau, was on hand to tell us about what's been going on with Farm Bureau and local agriculture. And that was very interesting, I thought. Updating where what's happening with local agriculture and how the coronavirus pandemic has affected them. An update on giving. Your president-elect, soon to be president, Doug Arnold, updated everyone this week with an email. The collected giving of the five Rotary clubs in Visalia, that's our Rotary Club and County Center, Sunset Rotary, Breakfast Rotary, and Latino Rotary together, and the district, District 5230, have collectively contributed to $193,180 to our communities. So that's terrific. Give them all a hand. Once we get through this, we'll provide a line-by-line update on our contributions to the community throughout this, as a result of this pandemic. And we do have some needs going forward, and We've all been asked to contribute to causes in to the needy in this crisis. I know that everybody's kind of like tapped out. We are. I know we got a few more things you want to do, and our board will be meeting on Tuesday to talk about that. But I did want to remind you of three areas where you, as a member of the Rotary Club of Visalia, can continue with your giving and your commitments to our clubs and to the community. First, the Rotary International Foundation. This time of year, we usually make a last appeal to our members, offering to match their contribution to the Rotary International Foundation with a contribution that we will match dollar for dollar up until $5,000. We have $5,000 budgeted for this for a contribution to Rotary International. And if you make a contribution of, let's say, $100, we'll match that $100. Now, this is important because many of you are close to having your Paul Harris Fellowship, which you earn with every $1,000 contribution to the Rotary International Foundation. We'll be letting you know in just next week or two. Rick Waymiller is working on this. How close you are to meeting your first Paul Harris Fellowship Award, or maybe subsequent awards. And then if you want to make an extra contribution to Rotary International this year, in increments of $100, we will match that and possibly get you to your Paul Harris Fellowship this year. This works pretty well. In fact, that's how I got to my first Paul Harris last year. And we're been keeping track of that. So keep an eye out for that message. Keep an eye out for that message from Rick Waymiller. Be coming to an email box near you real soon. Second thing, we make a contribution per member to the Visalia Rotary Community Foundation every year. And at this time of year, we also make a matching contribution to the foundation in your name. And if you would want to make another contribution to the Community Foundation, we will match that so that you can get your amount to the Community Foundation up to a Carl Weiss Fellow. And I think the levels for that are $2,500. So Wayne Yada is working on that, and hopefully we'll have that information to you in the next couple weeks too. That's another way for you to contribute. Finally, third thing, and this is for me. As you know, part of my role as president is to seek contributions from you members to my President's Club. President's Club are funds that we use to operate our club and also to do operations for the club, make contributions that our 501c3 foundation does not cover and that are not included in the amount of money that we raise from our fundraiser. Done pretty well, and I've gotten a lot to you, and I want to thank those of you who have contributed to the President's Club so far this year. Here they are. Your very unique, beautifully designed, colorful Rotary Club of Visalia bookmark that you will get for joining the President's Club this year. And I will be in touch to try to solicit some more donations to the President's Club. I've only got a few weeks to do that, so I'm coming after you. Finally, virtual meetings. We are meeting every Wednesday online, and I send out those invitations to your email box each week. It'll be in your box this week. Wednesday at noon, go to meeting. And if you haven't been, please join us. It's kind of fun, and it's a little different. It's not the same as meeting, but at least we get a chance to see each other and talk with each other and maybe engage a little bit. We do intend to have a full series of programs, guest speakers, and this week's best speaker will be Captain Yanni Escobar of the Salvation Army of Tulare County, and we We hope to hear from him about how the coronavirus pandemic has affected their activities. And I know it has increased their need, because we've already made one contribution to the Salvation Army as a club, and I think we're probably going to make another. I'm also going to ask Dave Miller if he wants to maybe bring some more photos for a travelogue this week. And so, and we have a couple other surprises, so we'll have some fun. Wednesday at noon, just click on the link that I send you an email this week. It'll be coming out to you. Should be in your email box on Monday. And join us. This week your board will meet to discuss a few things. We still have to wrap up. We're going to be talking about maybe having some different themed meetings, a funny hat meeting, a Hawaiian shirt meeting, a bring your pet to meeting, bring your spouse to meeting, whatever. We'll figure that out. We got a few other things to talk about too, as far as contributions to the community. We're also going to be talking about how we recognize and present our scholarship winners. Larry Nava and Jeff Moyer and Diane Hayes and their scholarship committee have been working hard on identifying those scholarship members. Every year, of course, as you know, we make $30,000 in contributions of scholarships to high school seniors in Visalia. And we're doing that again this year. We would have liked to have had a very nice scholarship luncheon to introduce all those scholars to you, but obviously we're not going to be able to do that. There will not be any school year the rest of this year. And I'm not sure we will be meeting as a club again until maybe end of June, could be July. More on that later, by the way. Anyway, we're talking about how we might recognize that, and the committee is collecting videos from those scholars, and we will hopefully have a chance to post those online at our website and maybe introduce them at a go-to-meeting, or maybe have them as our guests at a go-to-meeting. I don't know, we haven't quite figured that out yet, but we will, and that's coming up too. Finally, when are we going to be meeting again? Well, that's the big question. We don't know. And I have talked with the Marriott Hotel about their meeting again, and it will be quite some time before they're fully open for business. They'll obviously have to take some time and get that back up and running when they get the all clear, and they got some specific, some interesting challenges in meeting us and having a luncheon meeting there. We have been in touch with them. It's probably going to be several weeks. I would not suspect it's going to be much before middle of June, if that. But we will definitely keep you posted on what we're doing and how long it's going to take and what we can do to get together again. Meanwhile, we're going to try to get together as often as we can. Again, Wednesdays at noon. Those instructions are coming out every week. That's what we're definitely going to be meeting every Wednesday at noon online for our virtual meetings. We're also going to probably set up some extra meetings, some fun things. For instance, Rotary Foreign Affairs Roundtable next Monday, May 11th at 5 o'clock. We are going to have a little happy hour meeting, not a full foreign affairs discussion, but just a get together. And we're all being encouraged to bring the adult beverage of our choice to that virtual meeting. And I will send that invitation out in a few days. And then we'll probably meet as a regular discussion group for Foreign Affairs Roundtable later in the month. And we don't necessarily have to do it on Monday, because we're not constrained by having to go to a restaurant. We can meet at any time. I'm also thinking maybe to having a happy hour. Just a regular meeting of COGS or any members who would like to show up just for fun some evening around 5 o'clock, relax, all your work is done, all your work, yeah, whatever it is you're doing all day, and just no agenda, no business, just to have a good time to the extent that we can. Well, we'll try it, see how it goes. If you have any other ideas for meetings or other kinds of things where you can get together and have fun, please forward them to me. I'm easy to reach, paulhurley@gmail.com, or give me a call at 740-3677. Meanwhile, I hope that you will join us on Wednesday, here this Wednesday at noon, May 6th, and for our regular Wednesday meeting. I hope you have a very safe and happy Cinco de Mayo. It's probably going to be safer than it usually is, but anyway, enjoy that. A final note. This is the final note. We're going to make this our last Rotary Club of Visalia video message to you all, because we are now meeting regularly on Wednesday, so this will be the last one we do. Remember to attend our meetings online on Wednesdays at noon. You'll get the invitations out every week to those meetings going forward. And so we'll be meeting online, video, on your computer screen. I'll also be sending a message out, but we won't be sending any more videos out. So we'll see you in the meeting room, and hopefully see you in person in not too distant future. Okay, thanks. Paul Hurley, your president. Bye.